All right, thank you very much. Well, at this point in time, I would like to hand over to my friend who is here. He will start with Ujo, and from there, I'll take it over. So kindly, pay attention and listen to what we have to do.
The basic stage, when you open google.com, the home page, then you enter water pollution. So you are steady signs. You enter water pollution, you click on enter. They are going to have results on water pollution. Right? The pollution is a broad topic. We have air pollution, we have land pollution, we have chemical pollution, and we have biological pollution. So pollution is a very broad topic. You enter the basic stage. As a student, we don't need all that information. But we need exactly what we are looking for. And so once, as you can see on the board, our projector is ready. And this is the simple search using Google. And this is the advanced search I was saying about earlier. Now you can see that the advanced search, we have different tabs which enable us to refine our search, get exactly what we want. But with the basic search, as you can see here, there's only one search box. So for example, if I key in water pollution using the basic search, I'm going to retrieve items on water pollution, its causes, effects, how it can be reduced or how it can be sorted out in the environment. Now I'm going to the advanced search. But remember that with the advanced search, I have the option of keying water pollution. At the same time, I can tell Google that, okay, I want water pollution, but I don't want anything that has to do with the cause of water pollution or the effects of water pollution. But I can tell Google that, okay, look exactly for water pollution. Don't give me air pollution, don't give me land pollution, don't give me environment, because water pollution happens in the environment. But when you tell Google in the basic search that you want water pollution, it might give you items related to water pollution in the environment. But with the advantage, I have the option of telling Google that, okay, don't give me water pollution in the environment, but only water pollution. So I'm going to briefly go through each of the search boxes here, which enables me to refine my search. Now, as you can see, in the basic search, I key in water pollution here, and I retrieve it. And one thing I have to know about Google is that the topmost part of the results are news items. And the ones you can see here are sponsored lists or paid ads. But you also have to know that Google automatically sorts your retrieve results in order of relevance. So the most important ones are the ones that are displayed first. So in the more pages you do, the less relevant your search query becomes. So I'm going to try water pollution in the advanced search. So when I come to the advanced, I click in water pollution. Now, I'm going to tell Google that, okay, I want water pollution, but I don't want water pollution in the environment. So don't include environment in my search query. So I'll go to none of these words, as you can see, none of these words. And I key in environment. And I click on my enter. Now, we realize that I want you to carefully look at how the results have been displayed here. Water pollution minus environment. Water pollution minus environment. Water pollution minus environment. Meaning that if you should open any of these pages here, you're going to have water pollution. But it's not going to be environment. Just water pollution. That is what the none of the above sector does to our search query. It enables us to reduce or to narrow our search using the internet. Google has taken out the keywords and has displayed my results for me. So you can see that if you have water pollution causes or water or pollution. Now this all we are seeing here is a Google operator, but I'll not touch on Google operators much. But the all you are seeing here is a Google operator. Now we have three types of Google operators. We have the end operator, or operator, and then not operator. Yes. So I go back to my advanced search tab. And you can see that I have numbers ranging from, I have language, I have any region, I have any time, I have site or domain, I have anywhere on the page, I have show most relevant items, I have any format. All what these help you to do, they just help you to narrow your search. So I'll briefly touch on the any language helps you specify the language you want your results to be displayed in. The region helps you tell people that I want items from this particular country. I want items from, let's say, Afghanistan. I want items from Algeria, Albania. Yes, Ghana, Africa. And it helps you.
I'm going to take you to YouTube. I want to know how many of you have heard about YouTube. Anything about YouTube? So, who can tell me something about YouTube? What you heard? Or what you play? Or anything else you can say? Okay.
So, what is
that? Okay,
it's a website
for watching videos. Okay. Who else? One more. Okay. It's like everybody has an idea of what YouTube is. But today I'm going to teach you another interesting thing that most of us don't know about YouTube. Now, YouTube, as we are all students, and then YouTube is very, very good, and we can assess a lot of things as students. For example, okay, so I'm going to the page of YouTube. You just type www.youtube.com into your web browser. I'm using Mozilla Firefox. So www.youtube.com. Okay, so this is the home page of YouTube.com. I think it's loading. Okay, fine. So you can see a search box here. So for example, today I came to class and then we did the digestive system, the human digestive system. But I didn't really get it in class. So when I go home, I can just visit YouTube, type the human digestive system. Okay. So as you can see, when you type the human digestive system and you click enter, it gives you a lot of options of videos on human digestive system. a lot of options. So for example, if I decide to choose one, let's say I decide to choose this one, it's going to give me all the information I need about the human that distributes thing. So you can see that YouTube is not just for music, it's not just for entertainment, but it's for education also. So it's not always that we need to go and sit at the library, we need to read books, but there are videos and there are images and which can help us to learn. I don't know how to download videos. At this time, I would like to invite my colleague who will take you to another web database. Let's go.
Good afternoon once again. I want to find out, if you want to access information, my young lady, if you want to access information, where do you go? If you want to access information, which website do you go? Where do you go? Google. Yes, the lady at the back, what about you?
The one who's missing.
Google. That's great. How many of you chose Wesley Girls? Oh, no gay girl here. What about Percet? How's the Percet class?
Percet.
And what about the Purple Boys? Yes. What about the Molly Shaw too?
Yes.
What's good YouTube? Kate and Senior High School. Okay, if you want to find out information about Kate and Senior High School, there's a web engine which you can use to find information about Kate. And that is called the Ask. So that's what I want to give you a brief issue about Ask.com. So it's established in the year 1995 by two people by the name Garrett Kerner and David Walton in California. But before you know, Ask.com was formerly called Ask Jesus. The Jesus spelled J-E-E-V-E-S. Ask Jesus. And again, 2010, it faced a lot of problems, competition in the market. So it's changed from Ask Jesus to Ask.com. Ask.com gives you information on what you would like to know. And I'd like to confuse every one of you here. When you go home, since you are going to write your DC, and you are finding problems and find it difficult to understand or having problems with studying, you can just go to Ask.com and ask for the needed or answers you'd like to look for. It's very, very simple.